So he is just all around a really good.
Here we go again.
And a really good asset to have. Because you need a, you know, a player like Nico or Santaris or, I don't know, like, Beamers probably. Actually, that's an exception. But let's say, like, any star player who's, like, just really good and aggressive and good at shooting heads and stuff. You generally want them, you know, in those positions where they can have a lot of impact. But you also need players who can play the boring spots, like, you know, an B anchor or a Mirage or something.
Mm-hmm.
And that he's the kind of player who would be really good at that, probably. Because he needs to think, be able to read the game and think for himself, when do I rotate, when do I not? But when's mm-hmm. when am I going to, what position should I be in? So, mm-hmm. yeah. And also he was looking really fucking crisp, like he was so precise and, you know, accurate. He was very well rounded from what I saw of him, and he wasn't, the biggest part is he wasn't like, you know, the occasion didn't get to him at all. He seemed very calm during the whole match against Astralis, the whole team did. So, that's like the sick, most insane part about it, so. That takes some confidence.
Wow. You know who has been improved in NIP?
Who what?
Who is the player that has been very improved for 3 months?
No, I don't know, Nock, I suppose?
Yeah, Nock.
Yeah?
Nock is just getting all the entry frags.
Okay, interesting.
Yeah.
I mean, that's also really useful. If a player is good at that, consistent. That can be like one of the hardest things in the game. For sure.
Yeah.
Opening up sites.
I mean, Swedish players are always good in the game. They are just undefeatable.
Yeah. The problem is, like, they're kind of, you know, a rare breed almost at this point.
Mm-hmm.
They definitely need to get their fingers out. And I think I really like what Nip is doing. Like, they've let go of Twist, who could probably, like, you know, he's a competent player. He played Rifle for them. Or like secondary op sometimes, but mostly Rifle, and he did it all right because he, you know, he's a good pro and he can adapt like that. You know, it takes a lot more than a good rifler to, you know, play the rifle in a team.
Mm-hmm.
So, but he's, you know, he's been around for a long time, and
yes,
they definitely needed a proper
he said kid.
They even need, you know, it's at some point it gets necessary to, like, Nip is actually a, hello, wow. Nip is a very interesting team, because they're all young players. Like, Res is like the oldest guy, pretty much, and the most...
Yeah, he's 23 and Hampus is 22.
Yeah, like, so it's a young team, which is good, because Sweden desperately needs to get the young players, you know, in there. A Fnatic are doing the same, but, like, you know, at some point Crims and JW are gonna fall off a cliff. So...
Definitely.
Or, like, it's gonna be a... it hasn't started yet, but it's gonna be a slow, steady decline, like, all of my... Something will happen, you know.
Huh. What happened to all of my story? Is it still in phase?
Yeah, for now, but, ColdZera... Like, he is definitely, he's gonna get replaced by someone. But ColdZera recently announced that he was, like, retiring. Like, he said it on an interview.
Yeah, all of my star is still stand-in. ColdZera, Brookie, and Twist. Yeah, and Kirby went inactive.
Yeah, Kirby was benched for Twists. You have to keep in mind that Kerrigan's contract is gonna expire in March. So, like, there's, at this point, there's a 99.9% chance that he's joining FaZe Clan. Hmm. Because ColdZera wants him, FaZe Clan wants him. He probably wants to, you know, give it another crack without, you know, try again without Nico breathing down his neck, basically. So...
How do you know that his Kerrigan's contract is gonna expire at March?
I've heard it, basically.
Ah, okay.
I don't know for... It's not official, I think, but... I've been told.
Wait, do you read HLTV?
I do.
Okay.
I think I heard it on. I read it on some. I read it somewhere. It might have even been on Richard Lewis's talk show, but. mm-hmm. by the numbers, return or by the numbers, but yeah, pretty confident that his contract expires in March. It might even be public knowledge, I don't know.
Wait, Chris J.
He's in, I don't remember what, like Godsend or Fun Plus Phoenix or whatever?
Fun Plus Phoenix as a loan.
Right.
Interesting.
Yeah. You know that meme, minus Chris J plus Chris J? I mean, I wouldn't be surprised for it to happen again when they, when they lose Kerrigan and they're gonna struggle to find someone else. Chris J is probably coming back. Like, it's happened so many times. He gets benched one day later, the team dissolves, and he's back in the team. Kind of crazy. But yeah. I hope Karakhan comes to FaZe Clan. That would be a sick team. Really, like, he can make it a world's best team, without a doubt, with the talent on there. Like Cold Sera, an experienced kind of lurk clutch mm-hmm. player. Twists, obviously, like, can be a top 5 rifler in the right team with the right setup. Brokey has proven to be a very good AWPer. Himself can, you know, Kerrigan is the best in-game leader for building a new team from scratch.
Oh, that Kerrigan definitely is probably the best in-game leader that ever has put into Counter-Strike. I mean, just because, you know, what he did in FaZe is just so unmatchable.
Yeah. 6... 7, 8, okay. Like, he was the first guy to make an international roster and make it work.
Yes.
Like, literally, genuinely bring it to the, you know, first place. It hasn't been done before. People said it was, you know, it would be impossible. You can only play like 80% efficiency with people not speaking their native language. You lose so much potential. People thought it was necessary to have, like, you know, you couldn't be number one. But mm-hmm. he did it. And now it's commonplace to have an international roster. Even North, you know, dropped their all Danish roster. Or, you know, started picking up Swedish players. And the Finnish team. That was their branding. Now they're an international roster.
Yeah.
Like, and they're kind of, you know, everyone has seen FaZe what they've done and, you know, thought to themselves, hey, we can do that as well. Clearly possible. Clearly it can work. And it's probably a best option.
Well, this is going to be interesting times.
Yeah, and I like Kerrigan is rumored to FaZe Clan, and then Dexter from Renegades is rumored to Mousebots as his replacement.
Dexter? You know,
yeah, Dexter, the Australian.
Ah, yeah.
I remember, you know, he has been kind of a, you know, they've been kind of locked in their own region for a while now, but he did some, you know, he was very promising. He showed off some really impressive stuff. Well, the whole Renegades team did back when they were Greyhound at some of the tournaments they attended.
Yeah, just so so interesting that, you know, basically a team just getting to do another team. I mean, another organization.
Yeah.
Just basically just replacing them. That's how it goes.
Yeah, like that's how franchising works, you know. Some you can build your own team, or you can just sign. You can just buy the entire squad's contracts and then and have them under your brand instead.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, like, between the NIP 870 and the Australis 2018, who had the better impact in the game?
Better impact on the game? I think Nip, like, it's hard to say, like, they were both, I think Nip did, because on one, I think, like, the progress CS:GO has made would have happened whether or not Astralis had their like dominant period. Like the progress that has been made was like accelerated because where is he? Hello? Oh fuck. He's fast as fuck, boy. I wasn't even paying attention. So fast. I didn't think he could be that fast. It's alright, kind of. I think the nip thing was much more impactful because when they went into the game, these guys were legends in CS Source and CSGO, CS 1.6.
Wait. If you look at it, we have Forest, Getrite, Twist. No, not Twist. Oh, I need to look at it.
It was Fifflarn. It was Fifflarn. It was Freiburg, Getrite, Forest, and Exist. So Freiburg was a legend in Source.
Not Piff.
Exist.
Oh, Exist.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hey, man.
Hello. I just continued.
What's your name?
What's
my name? Yeah. Is it Del?
No.
Yes. Oh, damn. Alex Janot.
No, Alex is Russian.
I see.
This is Logan.
I mean, Russia, you know, Canada is like Russian adjacent. I could just tell it was really cold where you are. That's what I guessed.
Somebody used the highlight message and said, delete this message, smiley face. Because the mods always deleting everything.
Do you speedrun Logan? Anything?
Not right now.
Ever?
Never speedrun anything.
Yeah.
Cool. What?
I have a speedrun page.
I am currently speedrunning. I can't look it up. I'm sorry.
He's a speed boy.
Is your castle
speedrunner? I'll look it up.
I'm a casual speedrunner. Yeah, you could say that.
Not a pro gamer like the rest of us, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
I see how it is. Not even an MLG pro. What are you doing here? Who let you in?
I have a clan on the MLG website.
Okay, I'll take it back.
We play Call of Duty tournaments.
Yeah.
It's very serious.
You a member of the FaZe clan?
No, I'm bringing it back to OpTic, you know.
Oh yeah, man.
The OG.
Represent. Oh dear. Hello?
Hello.
Hello. I love it with, like, the Black Widows, they say, let's make it, it's a bit bright in here, isn't it? Let's make it a bit more cozy. And they're like, they've been dead for 3 minutes. Like, there are no more Black Widows flying. I've killed them all. I'm too fast for the game. The code can't keep up. Are you from Canada, Logan? Did I guess correctly?
No, I'm from the United States. We've talked a few times.
I know, I just have shit memory.
Am I that forgettable?
I don't frequent this Discord enough.
I guess. I try to
play
that game every day, and I can't deal with those controls. They're awful.
Oh, this game?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. It takes some getting used to, for sure.
Vertical, Overpass, and the third map is... What's it gonna be?
Cool.
Inferno. All right. Interesting choice. It's pick vertigo, obviously, and I pick overpass, obviously. And the desert is going to be inferno. All right. This is going to be interesting. Yes, Leko. Smooching sounds.
I'm so tired, I don't know what's happening.
So tired.
Yes, I'm so tired.
Very tired.
Maybe Logan will cheer you up, right?
What?
Logan! Cheer me up!
Bitch. Please.
Bitch. That's all you could come up with.
Yeah. Hey, it made you laugh, right? So I guess it cheered you up.
Yeah, it's minimalism at its best.
Yeah.
Well played, I guess. Well done, man, well done. Okay.
Oh. NIP 2.2. These guys are crazy. Vic has 89% of win rate.
100 kilobytes per second. Holy shit, why is this so shit?
Why is it so shit?
Oh my god.
Wow, this server is a piece of shit. No way I'll download that. Gonna take like a year.
Let me see, how's your round going? Oh yeah, good pace. Oh shit, I jinxed it. What the fuck?
Why do you think I'm not saying anything?
Yeah, fair enough.
Oh my god. You dead? I did it. Is this it?
Oh, this is it.
Is this it?
This is it. This is it.
Cue the music. Flooded basement.
GG.
Thank you.
Wow. Round of applause.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Cool, man. 1840.
Very nice. Very, very nice.
Very nice.
I can finally rest.
Right. You can finally rest.